Real video, watching Sam struggle with her makeup for 30 minutes and have a panic attack. Greetings and salutations. Hey girl, hey, what is up? Today, whew, girl, pray to the makeup gods because there's gonna be a lot of trial and error for sure because we are doing another TikTok made me try it slash buy it for our TikTok series. I really enjoy contributing more videos into this. If you haven't seen the series, I'll put some down below as well as the end of this video. I'll put some on the screen for you guys to click. I've done a few from, you know, cleaning supplies, home stuff, all the way to, you know, makeup and makeup techniques. So today we're gonna be trying three different makeup hacks. Techniques, one for the brows, one for the eyelids, and one for the face. So we're incomplete right now. We barely have anything on. We got a little foundation, we got a lash, and I think, yeah, that's it. This is thought about, and lips, and we have our lips on. But before we get into application, we're gonna talk about something else TikTok made me try. So we've, again, talked about the skincare, we talked about the makeup, we talked about the technique. We haven't talked about fragrance talk, which is when there are TikTokers who know their ish in the parfum world, which I do not. I'm a beginner and I'm not really diving deep. I'm a surface level consumer here. So if you relate, keep on watching. They post these videos where they're like, the hot girl summer scent is this. If you're looking to make this impact, this. This is the experience when you wear that. If you're looking for this, those videos are super helpful, to be honest. I'm gonna put as many references videos as I can. When it comes to the makeup hacks, it's a little more difficult to go all the way back to the original creator because there's so many people, but I can't find like where it dwindles down to. But I'm gonna try my best when I give you guys, you know, some credit references on the side. But on the note of our perfume fragrance talk, I have a partner today that will help us in this category, which would be Scentbird. They've been supporting our channel for years, a brand that I appreciate helping me keep the lights on and just being a frequent, you know, visitor and supporter. Always a great experience with Scentbird. I'm sure you guys have heard of them, but if you haven't, Scentbird is a monthly subscription service that provides over 600 different brands of cosmetic, fragrance, and skincare. Again, we're focusing on the fragrance today. So I picked out three different fragrances right here. She's real cute. She's real coordinated too. And they also sent over two bonus fragrances, which we will quickly touch base on to show you guys. So the three that I picked are actually recommendations from TikTok. Like, I have seen the videos, I've heard what they say, they sold me on them, and here they are. So let's dive in to the cost, the details, and then of course the fragrances. So the cost of Scentbird monthly is $15. So for $15 you can get one of these cases with one vial containing 120 to 140 perfume fragrance spritzes. If you don't know how to use this case, it's very simple. You can twist up and spray like this, you can just pull it out and switch to another color, or maybe you're out and you want to switch to another fragrance, and all you have to do is pop it back in, twist down, and it's locked in place. Really, really, really simple. So the first scent I want to talk about is actually in this dark blue case. Very cute, and it's very appropriate. I might have coordinated them a little bit. She's from a brand I'm sure you've heard of, Versace. This is the Dylan Blue fragrance. So this was recommended as just an all-around likable fragrance, and I would totally agree. Out of 10, I would totally give this an 8.5. Great everyday fragrance. It has notes of like white wood and rose. I wasn't sure what black currant smelled like, but overall, as a girl who likes like clean, light, fruity, floral, this is the perfect balance of fruity and floral. I think the apple notes are right up my alley. If you were a DKNY apple girl, you'd love this. It's just more of a mature version of that, and I like it a lot. So an 8.5 out of 10 for sure from me. The next fragrance would be another popular brand, Gucci. This is the Gucci Bloom in this turquoise case. It has an iconic pink bottle that I see everywhere, especially on TikTok, and sometimes there's different variations where there's like prints on the bottle, so I think it's just different versions. But for the scent that I have, this has jasmine, tuberose, and also Rangoon Creeper, which I'm not as familiar with, but it's supposed to be a bouquet of flowers basically, and it's supposed to adapt to your body really well and just smell really great. It's a little off for me, and I'm not sure what it is. It's a little too rich, I think. It's just a little something. So I will give it personally a 6.5 out of 10. Not sure where I'd wear it compared to the Dylan Blue, which I think would work for every single occasion. And if you had like only 5 seconds to throw something in your purse in the morning, this would be it. I don't know. Gucci, I'd really have to think about. So she's not my favorite, but I wish she was, because the bottle itself on the full size is very iconic, and I just like it. Like, it's really easy to remember and simple. You know, that's something that someone like me appreciates. But last but not least, out of my three picks is my absolute favorite of the three, It's by Marc Jacobs and it is the Divine Decadence. The full size bottle is so freaking cute. It's serving you snakeskin, clutch, luxury, elite, top tier up here, like amazing. So we have this little green case for her today. I love the scent, 10 out of 10, absolutely. And it features one of my favorite floral notes, which is gardenias. And if you did not know, this gardener, not gardener here, when she bought this house, she decided to plant 10 gardenia bushes, 5 on each side of my house. And gardenias are not beginner friendly gardener shrubs. I highly don't recommend unless you like a headache, but they're so worth it because gardenias will take you on this journey to wherever you experience them. So my neighbor said, you know, my grandmother must have had those. Like, I remember this smell. I've gotten that from a lot of visitors where they're like, oh, my sister definitely had some. My mom definitely had some. And I'm now that person. I'm giving you that experience. And this fragrance will also give it to you with less of a headache than planting your own gardenia bushes. It also features amber, champagne, vanilla, and saffron. So if the champagne was not already serving you luxury, this is absolutely like the perfect. Take it to dinner, take it to your fancy day, take it to your meeting. You want it to hit, you know, you want it to get people asking, who's that? What's that smell like? What are you wearing? This is the fragrance to me. Absolutely love it. It's very nice. It has little honeysuckle notes in it too, which is all up my alley. All my favorite florals are in this perfume without it being spicy, musky, or too woodsy. So highly recommend that. The last two, which we'll quickly go over. One is very adorable because it is called Red Panda. And this is in our red case, of course. Red Panda is by the brand Sanctuary. So this is a brand that is contributing to organizations that help these endangered species. So the Red Panda was the original panda and it's unfortunately not doing so well in the world nowadays. There's less than 2,500 of them. So profits to this perfume go to the organizations who contribute in keeping them around, conserving their lives, and overall just saving these endangered animals, which is amazing. So it's an okay fragrance for me. If I had to rank it, she's also like a 6.5, maybe a 7. She's a little light in intensity. I don't like a super intense thing, but it's not really doing much for me, not with my body chemistry. So unfortunately, I would say I would go through it pretty fast, I think. So it's not my favorite. It's not everything in the world, but it's not bad. The last fragrance is from Confessions of a Rebel. I haven't heard of this brand, but the bottle looks really cool. It's called Let's Be Real, and I have it in the yellow case right now. So this is something that is very warm. It's the warmest out of all the fragrances. This serves me fall, hot cocoa by the fire, s'mores, sweater, up to here, cashmere. Something about it is just like cashmere. Is if it could be liquid, would be here. And that's not fully my vibe. Again, like, I like fresh and fruity, but if you like that central warmth to it, you might really like this. So those are the 5 I have for you guys today. I hope you guys enjoyed my beginner amateur ranking system. I forgot to give the last one a score. I would give her a 5 out of 10. For me, it's not my thing, but it might be yours. If you are gonna check out Scentbird, make sure you use my code SAM to save that 30% off. And thank you, Scentbird, again for partnering with me today and letting me have this ability to try out all these fancy fragrances, because this is the only way I experience fragrance. I literally only do Scentbird. I don't even walk by the fragrance area and all of a sudden be like, anymore. Like, I don't care. Scentbird gives me the info I need. So we're gonna get into the application and start with our brows. That'll be hack number 1. And this is from MUA Ali. I hope I'm saying this correctly. It is a interesting technique. So it's supposed to give you like these really pretty simple brow hack brows, and it's supposed to be great for beginners. I'm sure you're wondering why my brows are red. I'm sure someone's already commented or is confused. If you haven't been keeping up, I got my eyebrows removed. My microblading has been removed in this area as well as the ends, where you can kind of see the foundation's a little over it. It's pretty easy to cover on the ends. And I usually have them covered with like eyebrow powder in the front while it's healing. It's gonna take a little bit of retinol and vitamin C to make the redness go away. But I'm basically gonna be changing my stroke pattern in the front and the angle of the back. So removal was needed to then get fresher strokes because they're like over half a decade old already. And now I laminate my brows compared to before and they need a new shape. Anywho, that's why they look like that. So they're doing fine, and hopefully they're gonna do a lot better after this brow hack. I don't know what pencil I wanna use. I'm between the Hourglass Soft Brunette Arch Pencil, which is like amazing. It's very, very fine though, so good for certain situations. And then I also have been favoring the Medium Brow Aqua Resist Pencil from Makeup Forever, which is actually a little newer. It's also pretty narrow as far as the application goes, but the arch one is very micro. It's super micro. So in the TikTok, you can see there's some sort of equation formation calculation going on with where you draw these lines, and then you just blend. So I feel like I can do this. I I went to college for 2 years. I can do this. I can't do this. Let's start with the Aqua Resist and see how it goes. So it seems like you, I'm so nervous. You go here, okay. And then we're going up to the arch. I think my line's kind of messed up. Up to the arch and then out here. Okay, do you guys see what I did? So it's like a doot, 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 like a little Harry Potter tribute. You can kind of see a little bit of there. And then you connect the top. Oh God, why did it not look straight? Okay, it's supposed to look straight up there. That didn't work out. Let's try a little bit straighter. Okay, it's supposed to be straight up there, but a straight connection, I don't know, maybe I'm not as beginner friendly as I thought. And then this connects here, okay. So you see there's like kind of like a diamond with a line going through it right here. And then the front, you do 1, 2, 3. I think I was supposed to go that way with it. And then you're supposed to blend it together and it'd be okay. Thinking I might want to use some of the arch pencil for the front. Just a few strokes right there. I'm gonna do the same to the other side just so we're on the same page. So a little diagonal angle here, a little up to the arch. Okay, diagonal up here, connect. Okay, connect 4. Over here again. So okay, and then we connect here. Oh gosh. It's like where my brows located. I got a lot of eyebrow fat right there and I want it to be sharper. Okay, and then okay, little 1, 2, 3. I might need a few extra strokes in the front here. I'm missing some brow hair. I think this one's a little higher than the other one. It's not too bad, right? Okay, kind of. I look crazy. And now it's supposed to be really simple, like you just blend. Up right here. I feel like it's just kind of fading away. Granted, the top right here, it has nothing to do with the actual brow powder itself. I have like a little bit of residue from laminating my brows, but that's like up here on my forehead. The brow itself should be fine, but I don't think it's doing it yet. Okay, I think I missed some steps. I think I'm supposed to give a few strokes in here, like a few right there. Oh, and then these go this way, they say. Ah! I broke the pencil. So you're supposed to like do a few more flick ups. Okay, let's try to get this back on the face. There was a thing there, and a thing there, and I broke it again, and a thing there, and a diagonal with this diamond. Stroke, 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 stroke. Okay, and now brush. That's better. Got a little messy spot right there, but better. Okay, it's serving something. It's somewhere there. Like, I'm not mad at it. It's not really helping that area, but I'm not mad at it. It's kind of like painting a guideline on, similar to like when you do strings, like they use like ink and strings when they do your microblading to make sure your brows look even. Like, it's a way to kind of keep it structured in your arch point the same way compared to using like a stencil. So I feel like it helps a lot when you have hair, because when you don't have hair, then as you're blending, like, you know, you're gonna lose a little bit more. So in the areas I'm lacking hair, it's not really doing it for me. Like, it's, you know, super lightweight, but it's not bad. Oh, it looks better from when I turned my head. It's not bad, but we're gonna need to fill in spots. It's helped kind of shape the brow though. I don't mind that. But if you have uneven hair like me, I don't think it's as simple as, oh my God, like it worked, you know? Like, I have no brow pencil left. Okay. Adding a few little front strokes with my usual ink pencil. This is by Urban Decay. It's almost there on this side. This side didn't get the memo. So I think I have more hair towards the bottom. It's just looking a little messier. Like, okay, maybe I can use a little brow powder instead. She's gonna need a little concealer. A little Jesus. A little concealer. And just filling in the areas that are a little sparse. Just have a little background color. Like, that looks good. That looks really good with that fresh lamination though. And then this brow is like, I do my own thing. I go where I want. I still can see the line underneath it. Maybe I didn't blend enough. I want the same established line that it has on that side. It doesn't seem to be establishing. She look good. We're gonna have to find her, so I'll be right back. All right, we're back. So they're kind of there. I know it's a little like intense of a brow probably because like the eyeshadow's not on yet, but you know, we're gonna go with it. It's better. Like, we have a good brow and we have a brow that's getting our participation trophy and we're cool with it. Next hack, will we be lucky enough? So the next two are kind of scary to me. So one has to do with cream bronzer. We have to do the cream bronzer first because before we do the eyeshadow, guys. So this isn't really a hack particularly. This is just a challenge. I saw a lot of these from Michaela recreating them, but this originated from Glamzilla, which I believe her name is Stephanie. So this is a continuous flow of cream bronzer, like from the eyes down the nose, around to the eyes, bring it around town, drop it up, drop it down. I think that's how it goes, and then you just blend it. So it's not like required. It's supposed to be like pretty cool placement, but it's also just because like the flowiness of it is oddly satisfying. So we need a cream bronzer, and the two on the table right now, one being Kaja. I love her. I'm really leaning her because I think she's the safest bet. I think she's gonna get us where we need to go, because you gotta use this with a brush. You can use it with a stick, but the stick might not be narrow enough to get on your eyelids depending on how much real estate you have, and I don't have real estate. And then we have this one. This is from Jaclyn Hill, which isn't super cream. It's more like dense to me, so I don't feel like it's gonna glide as well. Let's see if this is gonna fit. I'm gonna take off an eyelash at this rate with this brush. We're gonna go in with a flat brush from Laura Mercier, and she's gonna get it done. Breathe. Now stop breathing, because we all know we stop breathing when we need to do something precise. So here we go. Play Bento from Kaja, number two. I don't think this is gonna be enough product. I don't think I can do it one flow of motion. I think I have anxiety. Real video, watching Sam struggle with her makeup for 30 minutes and have a panic attack. What is this? What are you? I have a piece of my brow pencil sitting on my eyelash. Why am I here? I just don't get it. Okay. We're out of product. Someone send help. Okay. I just don't think I can pick up that much. How do people pick up that much freaking product? Okay, bring it around. No, we're gonna need a lot more product than that. Bring it around. Bring it. You can really see like where I start to run out of product. Double checking my references. She did this with her eyes closed, which was even more amazing. I could not do it. There would be no planet where I could do this in one fluid motion without losing an eyebrow with my eyes closed. Like, that was skill. So shout out to Glamzilla for just letting us all know that we're just not worthy. And I'm okay with that, because this is the best it's gonna get. All right, we got a sponge and we got hopes and dreams. So we're gonna blend. I didn't really touch base with you guys about what foundation I'm wearing, but I am wearing the Orsay foundation. So they're Come Closer? I believe it's Come Closer Foundation. I have a 20% off code if anyone would like it. I will provide it in the info box. So that's been sitting on my face for a bit. And I'm wearing shade 40. So I'm like 40 on my face if I don't match my shoulders, or 50 right now because I'm summer. But 40 is usually fine other times of the year. I'm currently wearing 40 just because I knew we were doing this and I knew it could have possibly gotten really heavy-handed, really quick. I love the formulation of this cream bronzer though, because it can literally save lives. So there we are, being extra, just bronzing it up, doing it up, making sure we get it all. The starting point over here was a little, you know, I think it was supposed to connect. I don't know, she started here, and so I had a gap right there, but I'm just connecting it with the blend. We didn't lose an eyebrow. We didn't lose a lash. So I think that's a good day. I don't know about you, but that's a good day here. Just imagine if this is your first video on my channel, and you're like, oh God, welcome. We'll talk about it more later, right? Moving on to the most viral hack, which is terrifying, requires us to prime our eyes. I see a lot of people using this, which is the Juvia's Place Prep and Prime. I use it already, love it. This is shade 2. It's not super bright, but it will do. This is gonna go across my lids. I know we got a little cream shadow going on. We're mainly going to blend this towards the lash line without disturbing our current lashes, which are Kiss Falscara. If you guys care, it's the wisp ones. We're gonna blend this down so our shadows have something to stick to. I know the bronzer's like, does she not see me? I see you, you see me? Type of thing, but we just wanna make sure we can blend. We want an even situation. All right, and it's also really nice for cleaning up, you know, our brows. A little lighter than the bronzer. Can just get right there. So here we are, prepped, primed, scared, terrified, but it's just makeup. It will wash off. It's okay. We're not going anywhere today. So this method requires you to draw lines with your eyeshadow and just blend it. It's simple. It takes like two eyeshadow brushes and two blending brushes. Seems simple enough, right? I feel like this is where like the freeze frame happens, and I'm like, and the Coach Carter song starts playing. It's like, it wasn't simple enough. Sam ran to her shower crying. Blending brushes on deck. One is by Valair, which I love, and the other one's from Morphe, similar, so we got those. But to be honest, I feel like we need more of like a dome shape, so we also have, these are like from Rent and don't exist anymore, but you know, your traditional whatever blending brushes, so we'll have those on deck. All right, so for like packing the shade on, I don't have a bunch of these skinnier shadow brushes, but we're gonna try that. This is from Sephora Collection, Shadow 15. I have one from Valair, which is a little bit wider, as you can see. And then I have like more of like a flat if we can't get good control. So I have two ColourPop palettes out, and I'm leaning this palette, which is the Ménage à Moi. It's purples. I think it would be fun. It'll give us something to look at. We got some shimmers and we got some mattes. I'm gonna use this flat ColourPop brush. I mean, it's probably easier without the lash, but it's fine. It's fine. We'll make it work because, you know, it's just makeup. It's just makeup. Should I use all mattes or should I do a shimmer too? All mattes, shimmer. Let's put a shimmer in just for the heck of it. Here we go, here we go. All right, so I'm taking a more on the flat brush, drawing a straight line like that. Okay, now I'm taking, I don't know if this is gonna work. All right, screw it. Now we're taking After Midnight and we're putting that next to it like that. It's already a little bigger, already jacked up. And then a bit of Obsessions, which is a similar color but matte. That's where I think I'm gonna feel a little questionable, but I feel like we should replace that color, right? And then No Drama being the darkest color in the palette. And then we put No Drama. Yeah, that one color right there is just not hitting. I think we need to put maybe Miss You? Is that too much shimmer? Miss You will be there, I guess, instead. There we go. Miss You. So two shimmers and two mattes. We got Fallout because we, you know, don't have any powder on our face. And now we blend. Okay. This eye ended up a little wider out. Like she just, she's not structured the same. Like it's not the same lineup. It's A team, B team, but it's fine. So first brush. God, I don't know what I'm doing. All right, so I feel like I need to fix the front a little bit. The lineup isn't exactly right. Maybe, should I add a different color or just extend the front color? I'm thinking extend the front, like extend more to the front a little bit, like make her a little wider because most people went farther onto their inner corner. I don't think I had enough shadow there, but okay, here we are. We're gonna just blend it out from the back. It's not gonna work for me, watch. It's gonna show how much skill and finesse I lack. I'm over here trying to be an artiste. It's already not showing much potential. It's looking a little patchy and maybe, you know, could be my luck and I picked a shade that just isn't, yeah, it's not blending out well. That would be my luck. Going with another blending brush. Just trying to blend out the darker shades. So I know someone's gonna be like, you didn't set your base, Sam. So sometimes I set it with this thing with, so sometimes with this primer I set it and sometimes I don't. I don't think it's blending out well because of the formulation. You know what I mean? That's what I'm assuming right now. So I'm gonna give this hack another chance and we're gonna clear off our eyes. And we're back. We're going to a different palette. Eyes are prepped. But am I? Gosh. All right, so we're gonna start with the lightest shade, which is Gilded. I was like, what is Builded? Bigger shader brush, straight down. It's straight when I apply it and then when I open my eyes, it's angled, but it was straight when I pulled it down, just for the record. Smaller brush, top right, Boheme, a darker shade. Still shimmery right there. I feel like this brown needs to be the darkest matte, so we need to put maybe something in between it. Maybe this shade. Yeah, I think that kind of makes sense. It's either this and this or this and this. All right, Charisma, straight down. We're going a little far out now. Looks great. Heavy sarcasm. And then the black would just be asking for it, so we're gonna go with the Tipsy, which is the brown. She's quite dark, so I'm sure she'll do a decent outer corner for us. The outer corners, man, I'm just gonna get fallout. It's gonna happen. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. I'm like pep talking myself. We can blend this. It's gonna blend. I feel like I would have been done with my eyeshadow already. Blending the top, pulling it out. I feel like we should rewind to part where I'm like, I love making these videos. Like I said, praying to the makeup gods is required because sometimes it can get a little frustrating when it feels like everyone can do this but you, you know? So that second to last shade is blending really easily. The brown is a little stuck. And I tried really hard not to press the brown in too intently. Kind of everyone does like one swipe, right? What if it's not enough pigment on one swipe? But maybe the multiple swipes is what's messing me up. I don't know. I don't know. Okay, whatever's left on the brush for that brown shade is going in to try to help blend. Let's just blend the front. And the front's easier to manage. Just reminding me of like the Maybelline like swiper days. You know, when you could like stamp the thing in the pan and then just on your face. That's what this is reminding me of, which didn't work for me then. But I'm not surprised that the front's fine. I'm more like, why is the outer corner just so jacked? Maybe it's just like too, maybe it's better to apply from down up, you know what I mean? Like, so the amount of pigment is towards the bottom rather than getting stuck right there. So like maybe I'm supposed to swipe like that, you know? Maybe that's it. But no, everyone else pulls it down as well. So I don't know why it's not it yet. I have a feeling this is gonna take a while to blend. Like, it's gonna happen, but it's gonna take a while. So here we are, currently still 28. So we'll see if I can do this before I turn 29. Keep in mind, I have not picked up any additional product that, you know, I haven't told you about. Like, I'm currently just trying to blend my life together. So when I, you know, tried the other direction, you guys saw that. Otherwise, let's go back and forth between our blending brushes. I feel like we're getting somewhere, kind of. All right, while I'm here, while I'm still here, I am assuming that it's the positioning. So depending on your eyelids, I have a lot of, like, you know, eyelid fat, slight hoodage towards the outer corner. Like, especially if I relax my whole face and I look up, you can see, like, it's quite, like, hooded without having to look down. It's like, this is me just straight to the camera. I got, you know, I got a good amount of weight there. Could be worse, could be better, but it looks the best on those who don't have that there. If you have more of that, like, flat angle where this is not gonna sink down when you look down, you know, like, if my eyebrow didn't have, it would look a lot better. You know what I'm saying? Like, it wouldn't look as, like, oh, because I typically don't want this condensed pigment right there because it just accentuates how heavy that spot looks. But that means I would have to do, like, micro swipes, like 1, 2, 3, you know what I'm saying? So that's, I think that's just an eyelid situation. Not all, you know, hacks and techniques look good on everyone. Like, it's not bad on the side, but I have less eyebrow fat on this side than this side. So that's just my assumption. I could see how the placement works. I understand that it's just not a time saver, if you know what I mean. Like, this is not saving me any time. This is taking me longer to blend than if I did individual shades, mainly probably just due to practice, because I'm used to doing it a different way. So it's not looking bad compared to what it was. It could be better, it could be worse. Here we are, it's cleaning up underneath. Get a little of an angle going. It's like all the way up to my brow bone on this side, but there's a little bit more of a gap here, a little bit better fade out. Lids are not particularly even, you know, like, it's okay. Hear me out. A little bit of face powder on the brow bone. Like, maybe that's all we needed. Sometimes it cleans it up and sometimes it's just there, but it's helping blend a little bit, I think. I know there's someone out there who's like, this is the only way I'm gonna be doing my eyeshadow from now on. And I don't hate it. Like, is it getting better by the minute? Are my eyes getting worse or is it getting better? I think it just started at a different spot in life, so it's tough. Like, I could go out and I wouldn't be too embarrassed at this point. For the sake of staking, even though, you know, this is basically the end of our video, we're gonna get a completed look. That requires a little bit of under eye concealer because we didn't do that yet. We're gonna put some down the bridge of the nose, kind of in between where we dragged our bronzer. I kind of wanted to do more, but I think we should do less. Like, let's just let what it is be what it is. No liner, no extra cheek. I'm pretty happy with it, all things considered. I think the brows has to be my favorite hack. I would give that an 8 out of 10. Pretty cool, would do again, not bad. I think it just gives you nice structure and symmetry as far as being guidelines. The bronzer is not really like a technique per se, but it was just really fun. You know, it's like a fun little challenge. And the fact that I couldn't pick up enough product means I don't know if I could ever do a one swipe, but I'd still give it a 7 out of 10. Turned out fine to me, doesn't look bad. The eyeshadow could also get a, I wanna say 7, but I'm gonna give it a 6. I'm gonna give it a 6 out of 10 because you never know how the shadows are gonna combine. I think that's the most risky one. A 6 out of 10 depending on your eye shape. And overall, it was fun, minus the panic and the patience, which is just a personal problem. You know, this is who I am, this is how I is. I hope you guys enjoyed watching everything. Let me know down below which your favorite, I don't know, hack, technique was. 1, 2, or 3, brow, cheek, or eye? Let me know. And if you made it to this point in the video, drop this emoji because I think that's a perfect representation of today's video. A little sweat, a little, but we'll be okay. It's okay. It's just makeup. It's all fun at the end of the day. And I am grateful to have you guys here spending time with me. I'm grateful to have an amazing partner like Scentbird. Make sure you check out all the links down below. And I will put my recent uploads on the screen for you guys, the other TikTok episodes, as well as the subscribe button for those who haven't joined the fam. You want to come hang out with me, watch me struggle a little bit, hang out with the struggle bus squad. We appreciate it and we love you for it. That is it for me today, and I will see you guys in a later video.